Hello, today I'm going to teach you how to make violin plots of different land cover types in R. First, I just wanted to show you what the data that we're working with looks like. So it is a bunch of buffered points overlaid on a land cover raster, and I extracted that land cover data into a different file. So the file that we're actually going to be working with looks like this. Only two covers, percent, and the land cover type. So this is just general information, just the summary statistics. I'm not interested in the specific composition of each and every buffer. I just want to know, on average, what is my distribution of my land cover like in across all my buffers. So we have the percent of each land cover type, and we have some different types of cover that we chose to assess. Now, in R, in order to actually make these violin plots, the only library that you need is ggplot2. So I'm going to make this a very basic tutorial, so I'm going to go through all of the steps and explain what everything does. So you are setting your working directory to wherever that file with your land cover information actually is, and these are the steps to do so. So mine is in my OneDrive file. And then after doing that, you can read in your CSV file. So I named the CSV file that I just read in as DF, which is comma notation for data frame. And another note is that header is equal to true. So header is always equal to true in a CSV when the first row is your column names rather than starting at the value itself. So we have header equals true because my first row is percent in cover. After you read in the land cover information, that CSV file we just looked at, then you can get start with your actual plot. I am going to open up the plot. I'm going to render this plot and explain what each of these things does, so that way you can play with it and manipulate your own plot and make it unique for whatever you're looking for. So this is just a basic ggplot function. So generally when you're using ggplot, all of them start with naming, just reading in that data frame, and then some kind of aesthetic, which is your X and your Y. In this case, X is my cover type, and Y is the percent. Geom jitter is why we have this little horizontal blotting at each of these sites. So rather than having all of my dots perfectly overlaid, the benefit of jittering them is that way you can look and see a bit more about the sample size at each site. So I can tell that I didn't really have a lot of buffers with barren cover, but maybe I had a lot of buffers with agricultural cover and impervious cover. So geom violin is what's actually going to make it that violin shape, and you can mess around with the width and the line of that. So stat summary is why we ended up with this diamond here. So that diamond, I wanted to include the mean, because while having the violin plot is great in itself, it's beneficial to sometimes, for at least what I was doing, to be able to see what the mean is as well. So function fun is equal to mean. Geom is point. I just wanted to see it as a point. Shape 23 is what made it a diamond. You can look up R codes for different shapes if you don't want a diamond. I just chose a arbitrary size. And so the color is set to black. You may be wondering, why isn't the diamond black? That's just changing the outline. So if you change the fill to something other than the color, it'll just keep the original outline but change the inside color. So I have a red diamond with a black outline. Theme is classic, which is why I don't have a common ggplot gray background with all of the lines on it. That's why I ended up with a white background with just the black border of the plot. GG title, so I named this buffer land cover composition, and this right here is what centered it rather than keeping it to the left. And then labs, if you don't like the original labels of your X and Y that you put here, you can create custom labels for your X and Y axes. So X, I changed it from cover to land cover, and Y, it was already percent, but I just made sure that it was written as percent anyways. For the gray version, I'll open this up as well, it is nearly the same. So while the color version is very pretty and it's very fun to look at, when you're considering publishing a paper with figures in it is generally more expensive to publish figures in color. So there's a benefit to knowing how to do this in grayscale as well, and still being able to distinguish between those categories. And you might notice that there's a little bit of overlap between some of the labels on the x-axis, but if you just expand this, it'll all adjust and re-render. But okay. So the only difference here, everything else is pretty much the same, except when we get to the stat summary again for our little median diamonds. I kept it as a diamond, but again, now I don't want it to have a red fill. I gave it a white fill so that way it'll have a contrast against the darker points in the background with a black outline. Again, I gave it the same title and everything. The only other difference that I added was scale color gray. So this clause right here is what actually created this gradient that we see. And then everything else is exactly the same. So that is how you create color and black and white violin plots of land cover composition in R.